Mr. Yevhen Siusko from National Science Center, Kharkov Institute of Physics and Technology, Ukraine, who is working on microwave methods with using refraction for plasma diagnostic. Whenever you are ready, the stage is yours.
Yes, I'm ready. Do you hear me?
Yes, yes, we can.
Good. Good day, dear colleagues. I'm Yevhen Siusko, a fourth year PhD student at the National Science Center, Kharkiv Institute of Physics and Technology. The topic of our work is microwave methods with using refraction for plasma diagnostic. My supervisor is Kovtun Yuri Viktorovich, PhD in physics and mathematics. Motivation earlier, these methods were applied for plasma diagnostic of solar coron and ionosphere. In addition, they were applied for finding the plasma profile, temperature profile, and magnetic field distribution. The motivation of our work is developing microwave methods with using refraction for plasma diagnostic. The methods are based on geometric optic approximation, which use the Snell's law. The microwave beam passing through the linear gradient plasma is reflected in it. Then the microwave beam reflects from the critical layer and finally re-emerge from the plasma again. We propose to use refraction for plasma interferometry. You can see that in this case, we through probing interferometry, determination of the linear integrated plasma density is impossible, but with inclined probing interferometry, determination of the plasma density through the peripheral layer is still possible. Also, the method for determining local inhomogeneities of rotating plasma via microwave refraction is proposed. This method is based on spectral and correlation analysis of the reflected signal from the plasma at normal and inclined probing. The approbation of microwave methods with using refraction was carried out at the installation where high power impulse reflex discharge is realized. The main parts of the installation are electric and magnetic system. The time period of the discharge is nearly 18 milliseconds. At first, we wanted to know whether the rays at 8 and 4 millimeter hit to the receiving horn or no. By varying the density, we consider 3 cases. With this value of plasma density, the plasma is transparent, so no one rays hits the horn antenna. In the second case, when the plasma density is higher, we see that the plasma is transparent for the signal at 71 gigahertz. It doesn't transparent for the signal at 37 gigahertz. The signal at 37 gigahertz due to the refraction and reflection from the critical layer is received by the horn antenna. In the third case, the plasma density is 3 times higher than the previous one. And now we have a critical layer for both signals. On the other hand, the rays at 71 gigahertz still can hit the horn antenna. So theoretically, methods with using refraction can be used with fixed horn antennas. Here you can see the measurement scheme. The experiments also show the scattered signal at angle 60 and 120 degrees. The scattered signal at 71 gigahertz have a maximum when in plasma more than n critical. At the same condition, the signal at 36 gigahertz have a minimum. The interferometer with using refraction was installed at angle 60 and 120 degrees relative to the transmitting horn antenna axis. Together with inclined probing, through probing interferometry worked every time. We use the standard Gamma-Dine type. It is a calculated result of phase shift for the interferometers at through and inclined probing, comparing with plasma density. We see that using plasma interferometry with oblique microwave beams provides the phase shift measurements even when plasma density is more critical in this case. Experimental results. In case when a probing signal is received at 60 degrees, the phase shift can be registered even if a plasma density is above the critical value in the time interval from 2 to 4 milliseconds. The interferometry at 120 degrees measures NPL at a density slightly higher than the critical density. This is the reflected signal from the plasma at the normal and inclined probing. The amplitude change with time from minimum to maximum. It was assumed that it happens due to the inhomogeneities of the cylindrical rotating plasma. So we tried to model the rotating plasma by a cylinder with grooves. The cylinder with grooves was made in three different sizes, from the smaller one to a bigger one. The geometric dimensions for every type of grooves are shown in table one, in this table. These are the reflected signals. Line one is back reflection. Line two is reflection at angle 60 degrees. The amplitude of the signals change with time from minimum to maximum. We notice that inclined probing is more sensitive than the normal one. Third case, red one is inclined probing. To analyze the registered signal, we use the AC and cross autocorrelation function and cross correlation functions. This angular frequency is defined by this equation, where delta phi is the angular distance between the reception points. Delta tau is a time shift between the maximum of the CCF and ACF. We can notice that these signals have the same form as reflected from the cylindrical surface. So we can use the same procedure for determining the angular frequency for the plasma cylinder as for the mechanical model, and thus to find the inhomogeneities and the angle of asymmetrical displacement between them. Conclusions. A microwave interferometry methods and the methods for determining inhomogeneities of a rotating plasma based on refraction were proposed. Interferometry methods give information about the periphery plasma layer. The second method can determine the inhomogeneities. Prospects. At first, to use a method for determining local inhomogeneities of the rotating plasma together with Doppler reflectometry. In fact, an additional receiving antenna is required. And secondly, the introduction of this proposed diagnostic on the U2M stellarator. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Yevhen. Great talk indeed.